What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to That's the Tea. Today we're going to do something a little long overdue that's actually been sitting on the shelf for a while. So we're going to unbox and review the Mandalorian 1/6 scale figure from Hot Toys by Sideshow Collectibles. Got this a little while ago, and the office was unfortunately in a little bit of a transition phase between what it was and what it is a little bit now. Behind you, a little bit of a mess, but today we're going to focus on this guy and get this unboxed. So let's get started on that and see what's brewing inside this figure. So to start off, we've opened up the Hot Toys mailer from Sideshow. Like I said, been sitting on the shelf over there for quite some time, but nevertheless, here it is. Now this is the full Beskar Mando rather than the original. I felt like if you're going to own one, and this is my opinion, I liked him throughout the entire show. Like, we saw him in the original armor for 1 to 2 episodes, but I thought that he really popped in when he got the full Beskar update. And so this does come with the child, and let's take a little unboxing and see what's inside here. Let's grab the ever trusty, always dull knife. Take a peek. Ooh, he's got that new Mando smell. You know what it is. All right. Television Masterpiece Series, TMS-014, The Mandalorian and the Child 6 Scale Collectible Set. All right, let's take a peek. See what's going on inside now. With any Hot Toys figure, you wouldn't want to, or any figure at all, really, you wouldn't want to start cutting at the box when it's just as easy to just let it open just like this. Incredibly slow-mo shot. Oop, and then I dropped it. All right, let's put this here. Frame reference. And then we'll start with the front piece here, containing all of the goodies inside. And there he is in his plastic. So, quick inventory. Just taking a quick look. He's got his pulse rifle, the child, his full Beskar armor. Looks like 3 fireballs coming out of his able to come out of his wrist. Interchangeable shoulder plate, one to have the signet and one to have not. His blaster, about 5 different hands, piece of Beskar, tracking fob, the little necklace that goes around the child's neck, and the vibro knife. So this is going to be good. Let's come in for a closer look. All right, as we start looking at the accessories here, like I said, 5 different hands. So this is definitely the Anger Punch Moff Gideon hand, the Soft Punch Moff Gideon hand, Somewhat Choke Moff Gideon hand, Grab Moff Gideon hand, and Hold Blaster to shoot Moff Gideon hand. So 5 different ways to hurt and or kill Moff Gideon, which seemed to be the crux of the show towards the end. All right, so as we said, the blaster here, one of his little bombs, fob tracker, Beskar armor ingot, the necklace for the child to wear, removable shoulder plate here. I'm not entirely sure what these are. You're going to have to let me know. Once I pull them out, I might be able to find out. That looks like his harpoon that comes out of his arm, along with the vibro knife. Short burst of fire, and then looks like constant burst of fire when he's shooting out of his wrist rocket, which we'll see shortly. All right, Mando figure has been taken out of the box, but we've still left the plastic around all of his parts. If this is your first Hot Toy taking a look, or any figure really, they do wrap them in plastic just to keep them, make sure they don't get damaged, or they fall apart, or scraped, or scuffed. And as I did say, this was the full Beskar Curious. He did still have this one plate here on the left. One accessory that came with is the child, plastic, mildly posable, and I say that, and I stress mild. And then his blaster rifle with the disintegrations. Did a pretty good job on that. Little has a little clip here to attach to his bandolier as well. And then on the side of him here, he's got his pouches with where I would imagine the other bomb is going to go. And then his cape on the back, holster for his gun, and helmet. Now, I did try to take a look to see if the helmet does come off. It did not say so, and I didn't want to pull too hard, so I'm going to guess, since it was Mandalorian, not slashed into Jaren, that his helmet's not going anywhere. So, kind of preferred, so I'm going to leave that alone. But I want to circle back to this blaster rifle, because I think they did an excellent job at modeling it, right down to what the show looks like. Now, here is my recreation. Stapled against my wall here, all the way from floor to ceiling. So I think the one that came with the actual figure looks pretty good as well. Other accessories included in the packaging is a standard sand base, pretty common along a lot of Star Wars characters. It comes with a flexible, bendable stand, the grip to clip on so that if you wanted to pose him dynamically flying through the air, or jumping away, you can do that too. And his Beskar jetpack. Now, taking a look at the accessories, I haven't looked at this to confirm, but I kind of think I'm pretty sure the two extra fire bursts in the accessories packs is probably what comes out of the two emitters here. So that is more likely propulsion rather than fireballs coming out, which makes a lot more sense. You can judge me all you want. It looked like fire to me. I just didn't realize what the source was. Alright, we've played with him a little bit more, got him a little bit more bendy, and then here is the pose that we went with. There's a very just escaped the pit or some deadly monster, so you're taking shots at him as you're flying away. And you got the child in hand, legs up as you're disappearing from danger, and got the jetpack on, with the flames coming out the back. So really kind of had this pose thought in mind before I even unboxed the figure, but thought he would look just fantastic coming out of like huge battle, you know, not wanting to get the child in danger, so just beelining it for the Razor Crest or wherever the hell he's headed now. So that's the pose we went with. So all in all, fantastic figure. Really enjoyed unboxing him and posing him a little, even though getting that gun in his hand, really tricky. A lot of bending. So again, don't be afraid to move some things around. They'll bend. They will break, but they will absolutely bend as well. All right. So again, here he is posed, looking down at what he was trying to fly away from, whatever the hell it might be. Jetpack is on. Flames coming out the back. He's lifted off the stand, which I really like. If you haven't had a bendable pose before. Actually, this is my first bendable pose one, so it took a minute to figure out, you know, how it worked and what it could actually hold. I tried bending it far over so that the angle would be like him coming like this, and it wasn't holding that well, so I had to come up a little vertical and just tweak it a little bit. As you can see now, I'm banging the table and he's holding up just pretty well. Here's kind of what I'm left with. Flame, shoulder pauldron, hand blaster, harpoon, which I actually wanted to incorporate, but maybe when, oh, I don't know, someone I can put, like, pit him against, like, Ahsoka or something would come out. The tracking fob, which, I don't know, probably would be great if you just wanted to stand him and pose him. Not as much of a dynamic pose as I was shooting for here, but all in all, I'm kind of blown away with this figure. Now, if you haven't seen this, this is also available on Sideshow Seconds. That's right. Which is it's a little bit of a box damage, which this is not. This is from the original run, but it's 15% off for slight cosmetic wear on the box. The figure itself should be absolutely perfect, but a little discount for just some box wear, so hopefully that's good enough to pick up. But really loving this figure so far. What I couldn't figure out, and I'm gonna have to look up because I don't want to toy break with it, is this piece that attaches to the bandolier. Now, it's on a little bit of a swivel hinge, and it looks like you can like peel apart the little hinges and take it off, which I think that's what I'm having to do. But, you know, it's supposed to attach to his back, or you can attach to his back, but because I went with him holding it, I kind of tucked it behind his arm, which when it's in the display case, you're not really going to see. So I'm not too worried there. But any of you have this figure? What did you pose him with? What accessories did you use? And how do you like it? Leave some comments down below, and let's take a look and see what you all have. I'm really curious to see how you posed him. This was one that, like, when I bought the figure, I thought, man, it'd be so cool if he was, like, coming out of the crate dragon. Now, he did, using the little shock tasers at the end, but he wasn't holding Grogu here. So I was like, man, that would be really cool if he had come out of the dragon with Grogu and was just, you know, shooting the hell out of that thing. So that's where the inspiration of the pose came from. In any case, review is done. Figure is fantastic. I'm going to put him up there right now. So, again, let me know what you thought. Leave a comment down below. Give it a like if you felt like. And we're on to the next one. So thanks for joining me today. Really appreciate it. And I'll see you again soon.